Hello, how are you? So many videos on band theory I have uploaded. I hope you understand all the points. In the last video, we have derived position of Fermi level in extrinsic semiconductor, and also we have seen effect of temperature on Fermi level. Okay. In just a minute, I will revise the point. In n-type semiconductor, at absolute zero temperature, Fermi level is at the center of conduction band and donor level. In p-type semiconductor, it is at the center of valence band and acceptor level. And as temperature increases, in both n and p-type, it approaches the center. While in intrinsic semiconductor, it is always at the center of band gap, forbidden energy gap, and it is independent of temperature. So these points we have studied in the last video. Okay. Now we will discuss one law in semiconductor, that is law of mass action in semiconductor, and then we will see the equation for fraction of electrons in conduction band. So this equation we need to solve some numericals. Okay. So first we study what is the law of mass action. See, this is law of mass action, not in chemistry, it is in semiconductor. So first we talk about intrinsic semiconductor. Now we know in intrinsic semiconductor, number of electrons in conduction band is equal to number of holes in valence band. So the product of electron concentration in conduction band and hole concentration in valence band is constant at given temperature. Got it? Suppose N is the number of electrons in conduction band and P is the number of holes in valence band. Okay, then N into P, product of number of electrons and number of holes. Now for intrinsic semiconductor they are equal, so N equal to P is equal to Ni, we can write I for intrinsic. So N equal to P, so it is Ni square, and that is equal to Nc Nv e raised to minus Eg upon kT. This is the equation for intrinsic semiconductor. Np is equal to Ni square. Ni, it is the intrinsic carrier concentration or intrinsic charge concentration. Now we know electron concentration is equal to hole concentration for intrinsic semiconductor. So Np, it becomes Ni square, and that is Nc Nv e raised to minus Eg upon kT. We know Eg is the energy gap. And what is Nc and Nv? Nc is the density of states, or we can, in simple words, we say number of energy levels in conduction band. And what is Nv? Number of energy levels in valence band. Okay. Now we know the equation for Nc and Nv. In the last video, we have seen this equation. Nc, that is number of electron energy levels in conduction band. It is 2 into 2 pi m star kT upon h square raised to 3 by 2. Now we know m star, it is the effective mass of electron, and Nv, number of energy levels in valence band, it is 2 into 2 pi mh star kT upon h square raised to 3 by 2. And we know mh star is the effective mass of holes in valence band. Okay. Now this is the number of energy levels in conduction band and valence band, and this is the equation. Now this is true for extrinsic semiconductor also, means product of electron and hole concentration is constant at given temperature for extrinsic semiconductor. So first we shall consider the n-type semiconductor. Okay. So what is n-type semiconductor? Now we know the electron concentration. We have studied this formula in the last video. It is the number of energy levels in conduction band into probability. Now, number of energy levels in conduction band, it is Nc, we know that. Okay. And probability, it is occupied. Now, probability equation is exponential EF minus AC by KT. See, this equation as so we have seen it in the last video. It is actually Fermi Dirac distribution and it is reduced to exponential EF minus AC by KT. Similarly, what is hole concentration? It is number of energy levels in volume. Density means just per unit volume. So in simple words, we can say number of energy levels in valence band into probability it is unoccupied, because hole it is unoccupied energy level. So it is probability it is unoccupied. So it is NV exponential. Now probability for unoccupied it is EV minus EF. This also we have seen it in the last video. It is exponential EV minus EF by KT. So this is N into N, means this N suffix for N type semiconductor and N for electron. So electron concentration in N type. This is NN. And PN, P means hole. And again suffix N means N type semiconductor. So it is hole concentration in N type semiconductor. Okay. Now take the product of N and PP. Okay. Do it. Take the product and solve the equation. I will wait for a few seconds. Okay, I hope you have completed correct. NN, PN, this NC into NV exponential. Okay, now first we take this EF minus EC plus EV minus EF by KT. Okay, just exponential. So we take the sum of exponents, sum of the power. So EF minus EC plus EV minus EF by KT. So this EF will get cancelled. And so what we get? Correct. Minus EC plus EV by KT. Minus EC plus EV. Now minus EC plus EV, it is the difference between valence band and conduction band. And we know difference between valence band and conduction band is energy gap EG. It is minus EC, so it is minus EG. Correct. Okay. So it is NCNV exponential minus EG by KT. Now it is just our first equation, equation 1, and that is Ni square. Okay, so this is the proof. Similarly, we can write for P-type semiconductor. So here we write NPPP, electron concentration in P-type into hole concentration in P-type, NCNV exponential minus EG by KT is equal to Ni square. So this is the law of mass action. Okay, so how will you define it? Product of majority concentration. See this electron and hole. Now for P type, hole is majority and electron is minority. So in general, we can write the product of majority and minority carrier concentration is constant at given temperature and it is independent of impurity concentration or doping concentration, because here we do not take any term which is related to doping concentration or impurity concentration. So we can say it is independent of doping concentration. So this is about the law of mass action. Okay. Okay, we proceed to next point, that is fraction of electrons in conduction band. We will see this equation. We require this equation because we want to solve some numericals based on this equation. Now, I'll give just one example. Suppose we have 50 students in our class. On our roll call, we have 50 students. And suppose for my class, only 25 students are present. Okay. So, what is the probability that any one student is present in the class? Correct. It is 25 upon 50. Any student, probability that any student present in the class, it is number of students present upon total number of students. Okay. Now, what is number of students present upon total number of students? Yes, correct. It is fraction of students present in the class. Okay. So, can we say that fraction of students present in the class is equal to probability that student present in the class or probability that chair occupied in the class. Okay, so we write it for electrons in conduction band. Okay, so F of AC, we can write the equation. Yes, probability is number of students present upon total number of students. It is the fraction of students present in the class. Now we write the probability of electrons present in conduction band. It is F of AC is equal to N upon N, small n upon capital N. Now small n is the number of electrons in the conduction band which are excited to conduction band, and capital N, total number of electrons present in valence band. So out of capital N, the small n are excited to conduction band. So fraction of electrons present in conduction band is N upon N, and by our definition it is F of AC. F of AC, that is probability that conduction band occupied. Now so many times we have seen this equation, F of AC is exponential EF minus AC by KT. Now we know AC minus EF is EG and EF minus AC. Yes, correct, it is EG by 2. Because EF, we assume it is at the center of energy gap. So obviously EF minus AC is EG by 2. So if we put it in this equation, we get N upon N, that is fraction of electrons in conduction band, is exponential minus EG upon 2KT. Okay, it is exponential minus EG upon 2KT. Okay, so this is our required equation. Okay, so there may be the numerical given that at a given temperature, for example at room temperature, if the energy gap is 0.7 electron volt, find out what is the fraction of electrons present in conduction band. Or the problem may be like this: if energy gap is 0.7 electron volt, then what is the probability that conduction band occupied at room temperature? We have to use the same equation. Okay. Thank you. We stop here in this video. Now we are left with only one point, that is Hall effect. So in the next video, we will discuss about Hall effect. Okay. Thank you.